coast to coast, time for the Texaco Star Theater, starring James Melton.
I will bring you music as swiftly as a dove. My song will fly.
Oh, swift, my song will throb.
Welcome you again to the Texaco Star Theater, a stage full of music at its best and fun at its funniest, starring James Melton, with David Brookman, the orchestra, the Lynn Murray Chorus, our Texaco Time visitor, Virginia Haskins, and our special guest star, Edwin, the fire chief, to put the grin in the opera Lohengrin. And this is John Reed King. Car owners, you've got less than a month of spring left to make your car right for summer. See your Texaco dealer first and see him now for his complete spring changeover service. He'll change the old oil that could help cause hot weather breakdown, refill with Texaco Premium Grade Havoline, 100% distilled. He'll protect transmission and differential with warm weather Texaco lubricant. Safeguard vital chassis parts with Marfac, Texaco's famous chassis lubricant. Get in ahead of summer and summer car trouble. See your Texaco dealer first. Now here he is, your four-star singing host of the Metropolitan Opera, stage, screen, and radio, James Melton.
Thank you, John. Welcome, everybody.
Oh, James, before you begin, tell us whether that strange object in your dressing room is a horse blanket or an old pup tent.
Well, John, it's neither one. It's my old linen duster and goggles.
Well, there must be a reason.
Well, there is. You see, I'm driving that big 1911 Oldsmobile Limited of mine out at the Indianapolis Speedway this week.
What?
Yeah, you know, on Memorial Day, the sports world expects the biggest crowd in Speedway history.
But, James, you're not going to race 500 miles in that antique auto.
Oh, no, no. I just drive it in the parade before the race.
Oh, then it will be a good race.
Oh, sure will. Fastest one yet, they tell me.
Ah, that's what I like. Speed, speed.
Then you'll like this, Johnny. This is a fast ride with a 1935 Irving Berlin special from Top Hat, the Piccolino.
By the Adriatic waters, Venetian sons and daughters are strumming a new tune upon their guitar. It was written by a Latin, a gondolier who sat in his home out in Brooklyn and gazed at the stars. He sent his melody across the sea to Italy, and we know they wrote some words to fit that catchy beat and christened it the Piccolino. And we know that it's the reason why everyone this season is strumming and humming a new melody.
Visitor Virginia Haskin, going out gathering lilacs, musically, that is.
Aren't you going too, Jimmy?
find a sure amber, didn't you? Here's the English love song, We'll Gather Lilacs. The hero has a white swan to pull his boat, a beautiful bird that disappears in the third act. Now, tonight, Lohengrin gets the bird again, and here's the man who gives it to it.
The fire chief, Edwin! Hello, everybody. Hello. Hello, Jay. Oh, when you hear at the opera, Lohengrin opens, you know.
Yeah.
The hero and heroine live happily ever after.
Live happily ever after?
Well, I mention that now in case they don't like my jokes and walk out before the opera's over, you see.
Yeah.
But anyhow, this is... The hero is Lohengrin. He is the hero of the opera. What a put Lohengrin has. He has an olive complexion, and his nose is the pimento. His valet says to him, "Sire, what would you like for dinner?" And Lohengrin says, "Anything." This is silly. The valet said, "How about hash?" And Lohengrin said, "I said anything, not everything." Things like that annoy me, too. Suddenly, a courier entered. He says, "The king drank too much liquor. The king is drunk, and he forthwith his three wives." And Lohengrin said, "Oh, I see. King full beat three queens." I can't give you too much. Now, here. As he rushes, as Lohengrin rushes to the palace, the scene changes, and we see Elsa. She is the heroine. She has a face that wears on you. It certainly doesn't wear well on her. It's really a horse face. I guess that's why she's always getting hit. Anyhow, the king says, "Elsa, I'm going to slip something on your finger." Elsa blushes. She says, "A ring?" The king says, "No, a thimble. My pants are torn." Isn't this a wonderful opera? Well, anyhow, Elsa rushes. Now, this whole thing is interesting because at this instant, Lohengrin enters in a boat drawn by two swans. He travels that way because he's so far down on the waiting list for a new car. But anyhow, Lohengrin says, Elsa, I would go through fire for you. And Elsa says you should. You're not the hot. This makes them sweethearts. Well, infuriated, the king challenges Lohengrin to a duel. Lohengrin says, we'll fight with butter knives. The king says, a duel with butter knives? Lohengrin says, why not? What else are they good for? Well, anyhow, as the curtain comes down, Lohengrin stabs the king. The king yells, touche, touche. Lohengrin says, what do you mean, touche? And the king says, I want to say goodbye. In the second act, Elsa says to Lohengrin, Elsa says, you were wonderful in that duel, Lohengrin. Was that your first experience with cold steel? Lohengrin says, no, I once kissed a girl with a brace in her mouth. Well, Elsa says, now isn't it? Elsa says, why don't we get married? And Lohengrin says, oh, I was married before, but it didn't work out. No matter where I went, I kept running into my wife. Well, he frowns. Lohengrin frowns, Elsa kisses him, and he smiles. In fact, Lohengrin. Well, so they go, they go to a judge. The judge says to Lohengrin, to marry this woman will cost you $2. Lohengrin looks at Elsa and says, what have you got for about 3.5? Now comes their wedding scene and the world's most famous fighting song, called Here Comes the Bride. Now, entranced, that's the music. Entranced, Elsa's entranced with the music. She says to Lohengrin, isn't that a wonderful tune? And Lohengrin says, well, it's no onesie-twosies, but it'll do, he says. So 20 years later, they are poor, and Elsa keeps nagging Lohengrin all the time. She nags him, talks all the time. She gets the mumps, gets sick, you see, gets the mumps. And they're so poor that Elsa gets the mumps on the installment plan. One lump at a time. Oh, she nags all the time. And the doctor puts a thermometer in Elsa's mouth and says to her, keep your mouth shut for 5 minutes, and she does. And Lohengrin says, say, Doc, what'll you take for that thing? Elsa dies. I think that's sad, personally. Elsa dies. The doctor says to her husband, did your wife say anything before she died? And Lohengrin says, yes, she talked continually for the last 10 years. Well, the following year, I cannot wait. The following year, Lohengrin makes a fortune as a painter. He only paints no vacancy signs, you see. And as the curtain comes down, Lohengrin writes his will. And when he reads his will, he notices that he has given everything he owns away. And realizing that he has left himself without a cent, he commits suicide. Play that.
Stay tuned in to the Texaco Star Theater, starring James Melton with David Brookman, the orchestra, the Lynn Murray Chorus, our Texaco Time visitor, Virginia Haskins, special guest star Ed Wynn, and your announcer, John Reed King.
Long ago, the great and lonely poet Goethe wrote several passages of verse that were so poignant that as time went on, the poem was set to music several times. Music of only one of these composers has weathered the years that have passed, inspired score of a man whose anniversary month this is, Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. The song, None But the Lonely Heart.
For all from joy.
James? Yes, James, sir. I'd like to tackle the chief again about making him car conscious.
Well, I'm afraid, John, that the chief will stick to his horse, but we'll see. Oh, chief.
Yes, James.
Well, John Reed King here, well, he wants you to buy a car.
Yeah. Cars are silly to me.
No.
Well, look here, a girl stole an automobile the other day, and the police found out that she was a brunette who dyed her hair red, then she bleached her hair blonde. So they sent out an alarm. They said, look out for a woman with a convertible top. To me, that's silly.
Convertible top or no convertible top, car owners, the best talk you can hear about gasoline these days is from almost any user of Sky Chief, Texaco's premium gasoline.
Oh, I see.
I'm going to use some tonight, Chief.
Are you?
By the way, is it cold enough out for my coat?
Yes, and for your pants, too, tonight.
Oh, Chief. Yes. Drivers from coast to coast become Sky Chief enthusiasts.
I see.
They like to tell how smartly, how eagerly their car starts with Sky Chief in the tank. How Sky Chief's surging power fairly lifts their car to cruising speed. How Sky Chief opens up so magnificently, yet throttles down so smoothly in the tight spots.
I can't get the name of the product.
These drivers don't need to know what's behind Sky Chief's amazing flexibility, the important Texaco developments in superior firepower.
Sounds wonderful.
They're interested in results.
Well, my uncle gets results with that Sky Chief gathering. He took me for a ride last Sunday. I said, Uncle, I wish you wouldn't go around the corner so fast. I said, it frightens me.
Yeah.
My uncle said, well, don't get scared. Do what I do. When I go around the corners, I shut my eyes.
Well, don't shut your eyes to this, Chief.
Oh.
Drivers can feel behind the wheel the difference in this luxury Sky Chief power.
I understand.
You'll feel this extra driving thrill, too, and talk about it when you stop at your Texaco dealers and fill up with Sky Chief.
Yes.
The premium gasoline for those who want the best.
I'll stick to my horse.
Oh, Chief.
Well, they're safer.
Now, just a minute, Chief. Right now, there is a campaign for safety driving.
Well, you don't have to tell me. I'm the head of the whole campaign.
You are?
I just got a letter from a woman about that thing.
Well, what does she write, Chief?
Well, here's the letter. It says, dear Chief, I read where people should wear light clothes so that car drivers can see them clearer.
Yeah.
And then she asked me, she said, should I stop wearing black dresses?
Well, what did you answer her, Chief?
Well, I told her it would be silly. I said, if a driver came hit you in a black dress, why, you'd be a darn fool to help the fox.
A few blocks down Broadway, in the hit show, Annie Get Your Gun, people are standing in line every night to hear words and music by Irving Berlin. And that's what you're going to hear right now without stirring from your easy chair as Virginia Haskin sings, I Got Lost in His Arms.
Dark in his arms, and I
20 years younger, a haunting European ballad came to America and began life as just another popular song. We know now that it's more than that. Len Murray Singers and David Brookman join me now in a distinctive arrangement of a song that has become a classic, When Day Is Done.
Since you went away, one thing is clear to me. You were dearer than dearer to me. From the moment you came, evening is by your side, I learned to love the night. But the loveliness of the night is no longer the same. Think of all the joys we knew, that yearning, returning to hold you in my arms. What good love, I know love, without you, life has lost its charm. Grass is wet with twilight dew. My lonely heart is sinking with a sigh. Although I miss your tender kiss, the
King, wearing a policeman's badge.
Car owners, the police traffic safety check now taking place from coast to coast is to help curb the rising number of traffic fatalities. The police may inspect the brakes, lights, tires, windshield wipers, and horns of all cars stopped for accidents or traffic violations. Every car owner can help by taking the lead himself. Check your own car now. Check your driving and check accidents. James, you better dust off your linen duster. The man with the stopwatch is waving his arms at us.
So he is, John. So he is. Next Sunday, friends, we are going to broadcast from Detroit to help celebrate the golden anniversary of the automobile industry. We being as follows: David Brookman, the orchestra, our Texaco Time visitor, petite Virginia Haskin, John Reed King with a lowdown on high octane, our special guest, Fire Chief Edwin, and I'll be around with various combinations of Do, Re, Mi, Fa, and so on. Until then, this is faithfully yours, James Melton, now saying good night and see you Sunday.
Texaco dealers from coast to coast invite you to tune in next Sunday for another performance of the Texaco Star Theater. And to drive in anytime, remember, you're welcome. Whenever you hear the siren and bell, think of Texaco. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.